Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome, welcome, welcome to our Bing Nursery School performance series. And I have to tell you, this is the sixth year of this. It's hard to believe. But thank you very much to some of our generous donors, the Luxo family. I think they're here. And Rita Coombs Whitney and Taylor Whitney, thank you so much for all these years. You've supported this series, and it's been such a success. So thank you. So today, I also want to thank Beth Wise and Jawa Ye, who without Beth's energy, her creative energy, and Jawa's masterful work on putting a program together for you, it's been a huge help in getting this off the ground. So thank you, guys. Yeah. So today, we're very, very lucky because today we have the entire Stanford Symphony here with us today, along with Paul Phillips, and who's the conductor, and also the Fratello Marionette. So if you've been to any of our performances before, you might remember them. So it's going to be a wonderful time, and we will sit back on your seat and enjoy, okay? Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. That is the Stanford Symphony Orchestra in all its glory. My name is Paul Phillips. I'm the conductor of the symphony, and we're so happy to be giving this concert for you today. Who's never been to an orchestra concert before? Let me hear. If you've never been to an orchestra concert, let me hear you. A little louder than that, if you've never been to an orchestra concert. Okay, all right. Well, you're in for a treat. You're going to see a great marionette troupe who's going to join us in a few minutes. And we're also going to try to give you a chance to hear almost every member of the orchestra, at least almost every instrument of the orchestra. The piece we just started our concert with is called The Ride of the Valkyries. It's by Richard Wagner. It's from an opera. I'm not going to tell you about the whole opera. That would take the whole hour and you'd be very bored. But I think you probably did notice that there were some very powerful instruments that play in the back of the orchestra, the brass instruments. Now, they might be hidden by the screen here, so you might want to look in your program where it shows a layout of the whole orchestra. And you see where the brass instruments are? See if you can find the French horn. That sounds, it looks like that. It's the coolest looking instrument in the orchestra, and it sounds like this. Thank you, Jake. Now, next to the horns are the trumpets. I love the trumpets. That's the instrument that I played in the orchestra back in my orchestra days. And I think Colin is gonna play a few notes for us on the trumpet. Thank you for that little bit of Beethoven. Next to the trumpets, we have the very unique slide trombone. And let's hear what the trombone sounds like. Short and sweet. The lowest instrument in the brass family is the tuba, the bass tuba. You can see it. It's enormous, and it sounds like this. Now, if you put them all together, this is what it sounds like. That we just played featured the brass instruments. Our next piece is all about the woodwind instruments. It's called Funeral March of a Marionette. And I want to give you a quick listen to what the woodwinds sound like. We're going to start with the lowest woodwind, which is the bassoon. And the bassoons sound like this. Yes. Now, bassoon is called a double reed instrument. It has two little reeds that vibrate together. And there's only one other instrument like that in the orchestra, and it's the oboe. It's a higher version of a double reed. The oboe sounds like this. Then we know the... Thank you. Thank you, Kenneth. Then we have the flute and the piccolo, shiny silver instruments, and they sound like this. Okay, thank you. And the main instrument in the marionette piece that we're about to play is the clarinet. The clarinet has the main melody. It's a very mellow instrument, actually made out of wood, like woodwind instruments are originally were all made out of wood. And the clarinet sounds like this. Thank you. I think we're ready. And so now it's my great pleasure to welcome to the stage the Fratello Marionettes to join us on Funeral March of a Marionette. Thank you. Okay, how'd you like the marionettes? I'm glad, because there's lots more to come. Our next piece features the marionettes again, and it also features an instrument that we haven't heard yet. You've heard all the brass instruments, you've heard all the woodwind instruments. Well, this next instrument is a cross between a brass instrument and a woodwind instrument. It plays with a reed, like a woodwind instrument, but it's made out of brass. It's a saxophone, it looks like that. And it sounds like this. Thank you, Austin. We have another beautiful instrument that hasn't played yet and does play on this next piece, and that is the harp. If you can see, we have two harps here on this side of the stage. And Jenny and Vivian are going to demonstrate the sound of the harp. Please listen carefully. If you look all the way on the other side of the stage, you'll see we have in the corner here a lot of percussion instruments, and we're going to show them to you, but now we're just going to focus on two of the percussion instruments. One is sometimes it's called the kettle drums, but we usually call it the timpani, and they sound like this. That was Sumit on the timpani. And now Max is going to demonstrate a little bit of the xylophone. Okay, thank you. I bet some of you recognize that melody. That's the melody from the Saber Dance by Aram Khachaturian. And that's the piece that we're about to play for you now. And the Fratello Marionettes are getting ready to join us. Here is the Saber Dance. Thank you. Okay. That was the Saber Dance with lots of percussion and saxophone and harp and piano and everybody else in the orchestra. Our puppeteers are going to take a little break now while we play a piece that I think is going to be familiar to lots of you in the audience. This is the music from Lord of the Rings. And this is the symphonic suite from The Fellowship of the Ring, the first of the Lord of the Ring movies. And before we play it for you, I want to make good on my promise to demonstrate some more of the percussion instruments. So you've already heard the timpani and the xylophone. Here's one I bet will be familiar to you, the snare drum. Thank you, Josh. Next comes the big brother of the snare drum, the bass drum. Thank you. Thank you, Francis. Often when there's a bass drum, there's also a pair of crash cymbals. Do we have someone on crash cymbals? Excellent. And you may have heard in this last piece a little bit of the woodblock. The woodblock sounds like this. Triangle is another good percussion instrument. Let's hear the triangle. And whenever we have a triangle, very often we also have a tambourine nearby. Now get ready for the last one. This one makes a big sound. Sometimes it's called a gong, but we're gonna call it by its other name, the tam-tam. Now, I invite you to try to listen, especially for those instruments, and this next piece. Now, this is The Lord of the Rings by Howard Shore. And as soon as we finish playing this piece, our puppeteers will be back for the rest of the program. Thank you. So that was a piece that really showcases the whole orchestra and all of its grandeur with every instrument playing. Now we're going to do something completely different, and we're going to do a piece back with our puppeteers. And this piece is played by only three instruments. Two of them are pianos that you see back at the back of the stage. Does anybody take piano lessons in the audience? Okay, so listen carefully. You're going to hear the two pianos playing. And in the front of the stage, we have Eric Royce playing the cello. Beautiful string instrument. And this is one of the most famous melodies of all time. This is the Swan from Carnival of the Animals. And I think if you watch carefully, you may see a, I'm not sure if it's exactly a swan, but you're gonna see a bird at the front of the stage. So keep your eyes on what's going on right up here. Okay, we're getting to our last two pieces. They're both dances, by the way. One is a kind of a strange dance. Happens to be by the same composer who wrote The Swan, Camille Saint-Saëns, a French composer. And this is called Danse Macabre, Strange Dance. And then after that, we have a Russian dance by Nikolai Rimsky-Korsakov called Dance of the Tumblers or Dance of the Acrobats. And that'll be the last thing we play for you. I want to make sure, before our concert is over, to thank the people who have made this possible. Jennifer Winters and Beth Wise from Bing Nursery School, thank you very much. And thanks to the Luxo family that sponsored today's concert. Thank you so much to the Luxo family. I also want to thank everybody in the Stanford Symphony Orchestra who are here on a Saturday afternoon to play for you. Yay! And of course, I want to thank our fabulous puppeteers, Kevin and Samantha. Thank you, Kevin and Samantha. Now, the next piece, the Danse Macabre, features the violin, and I want to show you something very important about the violin before we play this piece. Hiroto, could you come out? This is Hiroto. He's our first chair violinist. He's our concertmaster. And Hiroto is going to demonstrate the way the strings are tuned on a normal violin. So when you hear the beginning of a concert, it always starts with everyone tuning, and you hear a lot of sounds that sound just like that. But I'll tell you a secret. That's not the only way that you can tune a violin. Robert Hu is going to come out, and he's going to play his open strings, but they don't sound the same as Hiroto's. Robert's open strings sound like this. Can you play yours now? And Hiroto, you play yours against that? Hear the difference? There's a fancy word for that in Italian. It's called scordatura. Scordatura. That means changing the normal tuning of the strings. And so this next piece, Danse Macabre, is for a solo violin, and Robert is going to play the solo violin part using this scordatura tuning, and you'll see what a difference it makes. So here we have, as our next piece, Danse Macabre, featuring Robert Hu. Thank you. Let's have a big round of applause for Robert. And for the whole Stanford Symphony Orchestra, yay! Okay, this is it, our last piece, the Dance of the Tumblers. Have you enjoyed today's concert? I hope you'll all have a chance to learn to play a musical instrument. Maybe you'll have a chance to be in an orchestra yourself someday. There are youth orchestras all over the place, here in Palo Alto and all around. So all you have to do is get an instrument and start practicing. Okay, well, we've had an introduction to almost every instrument family in the orchestra. You've seen the violin. You've seen Eric demonstrating the cello. What you haven't seen are these instruments over here. These are the double basses. Okay? And they're very large instruments and they make the lowest sound in the string section. Here's what they sound like all together. Nicely done. Now this section right here, you think that's a violin, don't you? But it's not. It's a viola. It's a little bigger than a violin. It's a little deeper than a violin. And it fills in the middle part of the range. So we have the double basses on the bottom, and then come the cellos, and all the way on the top we have the violin. And in that all-important middle register, that's the viola's domain. And let's listen to the violas now. Nicely done. So now you've heard everybody. And we're going to wrap up our program with the wonderful Fratello Marionettes, with the Dance of the Tumblers, the Dance of the Acrobats by Nikolai Rimsky-Korsakov. Thank you for being such a great audience, and we hope to see you again soon. Let's give a big round of applause for the Stanford Symphony Orchestra. Yay! And our wonderful Fratello marionettes, Kevin and Samantha. Thank you very much. Thank you so much. We hope you had a great time today, and I hope we see you again soon. Bye-bye.